Hi everyone. So in this video, we will be talking about burns. Okay? So हम इस वीडियो में burns के बारे में बात करेंगे. So first we will be talking about the patient with the criteria who are referred to a designated burn center. तो जो patient जिनको हम burn center में भेजना है, तो उनका criteria क्या होना पड़ेगा? तो patients with the following criteria are referred to a designated burn center. Okay. तो एक बर्न सेंटर में भेजने के लिए जो क्राइटेरिया होना चाहिए पेशेंट का, उसके बारे में बात करेंगे हम. तो फर्स्ट इज पार्शियल थिकनेस बर्न. पार्शियल थिकनेस बर्न विथ ग्रेटर देन 10% ऑफ टोटल बॉडी सरफेस एरिया. जो बर्न में मोर देन 10% ऑफ टोटल बॉडी सरफेस एरिया included है, and that is also a partial thickness burn, we send it, refer it to a designated burn center. Okay. Number two, burns involving the face, hands, genitalia, perineum or major joints. Okay. So those patients in which the burns are involving the face, the hands, the genitalia, perineum or major joints. Okay. So we send those type of patient also to a designated burn center. Okay. Next, number three, any full thickness burn. Patient with any full thickness burn, we send them to designated burn center. Okay. Then number four, electrical burns including lightning injury. So sometimes there are burns due to electricity, and sometimes there is burn due to the lightning injury. Lightning hota hai to kya hota hai, there is burn. So those type of patient also will send them to burn center. Okay, next is chemical burns. Okay, chemical burns. Number six is inhalational injury. Okay, then number seven, burns in patient with pre-existing medical disorders that could complicate management, prolong recovery or affect outcome. So iska matlab kya hai? Then there are some patient, okay, who have pre-existing medical disorder. There are some medical disorders in them that could complicate their management, prolong the recovery and affect the outcome. So in those type of patient also we will send them to burn care center. Okay. Then number seven, then number eight. Okay. So any patient with burns and concomitant trauma. Okay. Trauma, like he has got fractures. Okay. In which the burn injury possesses the greater immediate risk of morbidity and mortality. Okay, so kya hota hai, some patient who have burned along with that there is some trauma, so fracture ho gaya hai kuch, and in which the burn injury, that the burn injury possess the greater immediate risk of, so when there is high morbidity and high mortality, then also we send the patient to the burn center. Okay, then next is burn children in hospital without qualified personnel or equipment to care for children. Okay, so in those hospitals where there are no equipment to take care of the burn patient and also of the children, we refer them to the burn center. Okay, then burn in patient who require special social, emotional or long-term rehabilitative intervention. So there are some patients, okay, so jisme kya hota hai, the burn in patient who requires special social care chahiye unko, emotional care chahiye and long term rehabilitative intervention, so long term rehabilitation ka zarurat padta hai, in those patient also we refer them to burn centers. Okay, excuse me. So now we will talk about the pathophysiology of burns. Okay, so what happens, radiant heat loss is increased from the burn, so there is heat loss, radiant heat loss is increased from the burn wood, from the burn wound secondary to increased blood flow and integumentary loss. So kya hota hai, there is heat loss. Okay, when there is a burn patient, there is heat loss, and why does that heat loss occurs, due to it occurs secondary to increased blood flow, due to increased blood flow and the integumentary loss, that is the skin, the outermost layer of the skin is lost, due to that there is radiant heat loss. Okay, heat loss occurs also due to evaporation of water. Okay, heat loss also occurs because of evaporation of water from the burn wounds. Okay, this leads to significant fluid loss also, like sodium, potassium, wo sab ka bhi loss hota hai. Okay, so heat loss also occurs because of evaporation of water from the burn wound. Heat loss also occurs because of kya? Evaporation of water from the burn wound. This lead to significant fluid loss. Okay, fluid loss hota hai iske karan. The next, significant burns are associated with release of massive inflammatory mediator. So release of inflammatory mediators. So there is burn, then what happens, there is release of inflammatory mediators, both in wound and in other tissues. Okay, these mediators produce vasoconstriction, Like in inflammation, जो होता है same things happen here also. Then vasodilation, first vasoconstriction, then vasodilation, then increase capillary permeability and edema. Okay, edema locally and in distant organs. Okay, so what happens? Significant burn होने के बाद there is massive release of inflammatory mediators. Inflammatory mediators are released both in the wound and in other tissues also. And due to inflammation, there is vasoconstriction, vasodilation, increased capillary permeability and edema locally as well as in distant organs. Okay, then metabolism is increased. Okay, metabolism. We'll talk about the metabolism. What happens to metabolism after a patient suffer from burn? Okay, so increased release of catabolic hormones like catecholamines, corticosteroids, and glucagon leads to hypermetabolic state. Okay, leads to hypermetabolic state. Okay, so what happens? There is increased release of catecholamines. Okay, catecholamines, then corticosteroids and glucagon, and which leads to hypermetabolic state. Okay, this was about metabolism. Okay, then what happens to the immune system? Immune system mein kya hota hai? There is global depression. So immune system is depressed. Global depression in immune function. So what happens? Depressed cellular function in all parts of the immune system, including activation and activity of neutrophils, macrophages, B and T lymphocytes. So kya hota hai? There is global depression and there is problem in the activation of neutrophil. Humko pata hai, then if there is some inflammation, some kuch agar some emergency, this release of neutrophils happen, macrophages. In case of chronic inflammation, macrophages, acute inflammation, neutrophils, acute infection, then B and T lymphocytes are also released. But in case of this burn, the patient loses its capacity to fight infections. Okay, and there is global depression in the immune function. Okay, so next what happens? There are stress ulcers. Stress ulcers, also known as curling ulcers. You remember, not Cushing. This is curling ulcer. Okay, burn mein curling ulcers hota hai. Okay, so curling ulcer, stress ulcer of burns are due to decrease in mucosal defenses. So in case of curling ulcer, what happened? Acid secretion is not increased. Okay, but in case of Cushing ulcer, the acid secretion is increased. So in case of curling ulcer, acid secretion is not increased. This is a point to be remembered. Okay, now we will talk about the area of cutaneous injury. Okay, the area in which the burn occurs, the three zones we will be studying. The first is the zone of, draw it please, this is the zone of coagulation. Okay, we'll study the differentiating features of the three zone. Then is the Zone of stasis. Zone of stasis. Then is the zone of hypermia. Zone of hypermia. Okay. So this is the epidermis and this is the dermis. If you are guessing what is epidermis and dermis, you must go back to Munna Bhai MBBS. Then you can see that guy, he has been asked na to tell what is this. Then he speaks very smartly and says this is epidermis, this is dermis. So if you are not remembering what is epidermis and dermis, please do give a look to Munna Bhai MBBS. Okay, so this is zone of coagulation. Okay, this is zone of coagulation, this is zone of stasis, and this is zone of hypermia. So we will study about each of the zone separately. First we'll study the zone of coagulation. Okay, so what is zone of coagulation? It is the necrotic area of burn, of a burn where cells are have been disrupted. Okay, it is the necrotic area where the cells have been disrupted and tissue is irreversibly damaged. Okay, in this zone of coagulation there is coagulation, necrosis. Okay, area of burn where cell have been disrupted and there is irreversible damage occurring in the zone of coagulation. Okay, I hope you have written down. I'm preparing presenting my presentation in the form of notes. So even those who are preparing for their third year examination, they don't need separate notes. It's more than enough for your examination also. Then we will be studying zone of stasis. Okay, zone of coagulation ke baad aata hai zone of stasis. So which is the zone of stasis? It is the area immediately surrounding the necrotic zone. Okay, then here what happens? Moderate degree of insult, okay, with decreased tissue perfusion. Okay, so zone of stasis kya hai? It is the area immediately surrounding the necrotic zone. Moderate degree of insult with decreased tissue perfusion. Okay, depending on the wound environment, it can either this zone of stasis can either survive or progress to coagulative necrosis. So this the zone of coagulation mein kya hota hai? There is necrosis. But in case of zone of stasis, it has the opportunity to choose either to get necrosis or it survives. It can survive, not it does not get to choose, but it can survive or it can go to coagulative necrosis also. It depends. Okay, so associated this zone is associated with vascular damage and vessel leakage. Okay, fine. Okay, so next we'll be studying the zone of hypermia. Zone of hypermia. Okay, zone of hypermia, it lies beyond the zone of stasis. So this was zone of coagulation, this is zone of stasis, this is zone of hypermia. Okay, so this is zone of hypermia, lies beyond the zone of stasis, lies beyond the zone of stasis. It is characterized by vasodilation. okay, from inflammatory surrounding inflammation, actually, sorry, inflammation surrounding the burn wound. Okay, so what happens in zone of hypermia? There is vasodilation. Okay, and why does this vasodilation occurs? Due to inflammation surrounding the burn wound. Okay, then it contains clearly bivalve tissue from which the healing process begins. Okay, so it contains clearly bivalve tissue from which the healing process begins. So yahan pe kya hota hai, some there is clearly bivalve tissue jahan se wo healing process occurs. Okay, and this zone is generally not at a risk for further necrosis. Okay, this area zone is not at a risk of further necrosis. So we are done with the introduction of burn. In our next video, we'll be studying burn classification, then fever in burn patient, care of burn patients, then burn size and other things. So thank you very much.